Have you ever wondered how your smartphone charges so efficiently? How your CPU can switch billions of transistors every second? Or how electric vehicles deliver kilowatts of power so seamlessly? One tiny device called a MOSFET is one of the key components behind it all. Today on Engineeringness, we're diving into everything you need to know about MOSFETs. What exactly is a MOSFET and how does it work? A MOSFET, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, is essentially a voltage-controlled switch or amplifier, although not many people use it as an amplifier. Unlike BJTs, which were mainly covered in our previous transistors video, MOSFETs can switch electronic signals faster, use less energy, and are voltage-controlled. Firstly, to understand how MOSFETs work, we must first understand how PN junctions function. To learn more about this, check out our previous semiconductor video. To put it briefly, PN-type semiconductors are two regions of silicon doped with different impurities. This is because pure silicon has almost no free electrons. The P side contains holes, positive charge carriers. The N side contains free electrons, negative charge carriers. When the PN junction is formed, electrons and holes recombine near the interface, creating a depletion region devoid of free charge. This region acts as a barrier, preventing charge flow until the applied voltage overcomes it. Now imagine a P-type region with two smaller N-type regions on either side. Let's connect two terminals to the N-type regions called source and drain. On the P-type region, we connect another terminal called the substrate, which in most discrete MOSFETs is tied internally to the source, so you can only see three external pins. Between the two N-type regions is an oxide layer, usually a thin layer of silicon dioxide, and above this oxide sits the gate electrode, often polysilicon or metal, bonded out to the gate pin. If we apply a voltage between gate and source, an electric field forms across the oxide, inducing a conductive channel in the silicon between source and drain. If that gate voltage exceeds the threshold voltage, a channel forms and current can flow when you apply a drain source voltage. Let's use a pipe with water flowing through it as a good visual example to understand how MOSFETs work. We can block the flow of water through the pipe with a plate. One side of the plate can have a hole, and the plate itself can be spring-loaded. Another pipe connects to this plate with a high enough pressure or voltage that the plate can be moved, allowing the water to flow through the hole. The higher the pressure or voltage, the higher the flow of water. Types of MOSFETs. There are two types of MOSFETs. Depletion mode and enhancement mode MOSFETs share the same basic structure, a gate electrode insulated by silicon dioxide above a semiconductor channel, but they differ fundamentally in their default state, threshold behavior, and typical applications. An enhancement mode MOSFET is normally off. There's no channel and no current flows. Only when you drive the gate beyond its threshold, positive for N-channel, negative for P-channel, does an inversion layer form and allow current to pass. This behavior makes enhancement MOSFETs ideal as digital switches and power transistors, since you simply apply a gate voltage to turn them fully on or off. A depletion mode MOSFET is normally on, an intrinsic channel already conducts, and you must apply a reverse gate bias, negative for N-channel, positive for P-channel, to deplete the carriers, pinch off the channel, and switch it off. Its transfer curve starts at a finite drain current at zero bias and falls as you apply the reverse gate voltage. Because of this normally on characteristic, depletion MOSFETs find niche use in analog circuits, such as constant current sources or depletion load logic, and in RF gain stages, where a default conduction path is advantageous. Before we dive into the anatomy of a MOSFET, if you're enjoying this deep dive into the world of electronic components, don't forget to subscribe to Engineeringness and give us a thumbs up. We've got plenty more tech explorations to come. Also, check out our online store for unique engineering products and help us keep making awesome content. It really helps us out a lot. The anatomy of a MOSFET. Inside its black epoxy package, a power MOSFET is mounted on a copper lead frame that serves as the drain connection and a heat spreading plate. On top of that copper plate sits the silicon die, whose underside is soldered directly to the drain. The die's top surface carries two heavily doped regions, the source and the body, which are electrically shorted together under a single metal pad. And the pad, often with multiple bonds, is wire bonded to the source pin. ultra-fine bond wire connects the gate electrode, which lies above the channel region, and is insulated by a nanometer-thin layer of silicon dioxide. Encapsulation in epoxy protects this structure and helps conduct heat out to any heatsink or PCB copper you attach. Finally, the part number, laser etched on the top, lets you look up the datasheet for ratings like maximum drain source voltage, on resistance, gate charge, thermal resistance, etc. From regulating power in your phone charger to driving transistors in your CPU, MOSFETs are the backbone of modern electronics. Next time you spot that little three-terminal package on a circuit board, remember, it's not just a transistor. It's a high-speed, voltage-controlled gate that makes our digital and power world possible. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like, share, and subscribe to Engineeringness. Stay curious and never stop exploring the incredible world of science and engineering.